which I am showing here. And can you all see the, can you all hear me? Just let me know in the chat box if you all can hear me. I'll start once I get some responses. So, hi everyone, hello. Glad to see you all here. Hi Navya, hi Rishabh. Let me know if my voice is audible and the video is visible. Hi, hi, hi everyone. Just give me the response if the video is fine and everything. Okay, both are fine. Okay, cool guys. So here we have the reference over here with us, and the shades that I will be using today is black, both the types of green, brown, yellow and white. We will be using these for the cat's base and the background. Then I have water and my palette with me. Then I have a few fine liners and detailing brushes and normal brushes with me, which I will be using to detail. So I have a brush by Artishells, I have one by Shimoni Arts, I have the fine liners and the gold tacklon set by Brustro, and I have one which Doms gave in their own box. So you can use any of these, whichever fits in your budget. So comment ready once if you all are set to start painting with me. Then we can start it out, and I will be rotating this image so that you can only see the cat. Yeah, I'll wait a minute. Just let me know when you all start comment, when you all will start commenting ready. I'll just get started with it. So which paints are better, Doms or Camlin? I will be making a review video soon comparing both. It can be after today's live as well. So I'm covering this dog part so that you can see this part of the palette as well over here. I'm keeping my jar of water over there. Okay, my setup is all set. I can read the chat as well. Cool. Yeah, so basic difference between gouache and poster, I'll tell it. Okay guys, we are starting. So first of all, we will start by the eyes as usual. So as we did the dog, for those who want to learn how to paint this dog, I'll attach the link in the description. You can check that out and paint that with me. Okay, so now we'll start with the eyes first. I'm using a fine liner brush again today for the eyes part to block it. Now, basic difference between gouache and watercolor, if you ask me, it is mainly in the pigment which is there. So gouache are a little less pigmented than poster paints. More or less both belong to the same family, both are water based, like both have the color pigment in the same amount. So there is not much difference, just that poster colors have much more pigment, the color pigment, than the other one. Okay, now I am painting the eye over here. I hope you all can see. Just let me know in the comments if everything is coming fine so far, like you are able to see the eye, and if my speed is also convenient for you all. I can also zoom in over here, so I am zooming in a little. I hope this setup helps. Cool, thank you so much everyone. Just try to be interactive for a while, because here, unlike Instagram, here I can't see your chat, you know, throughout this. So yes guys, you can try to catch up with me. I'll go a little fast, like just like yesterday's speed. So either you can just watch and ask me questions, because I'll be more than happy to answer your doubts regarding any medium that you have. And meanwhile, I paint. So that's there. And if I don't answer your question, if I miss it, try to repost it again, because in this the chats disappear. Okay, are they better than Camlin premium poster? Yes, yes, I can say that they are better than the Camlin premium poster one. So if you want to go with a budget friendly and amazing colors at the same time, you can definitely buy Doms, because they are definitely better than the Camlin premium ones. I'm talking about the Doms poster paints over here, the student grade. I'll show you all the box as well. So let me just zoom out a bit. Okay, so this one is the set that I have. This is really cheap as well. so you all can invest, like spend on this one, and you can get started. Just that the Camlin premium shade that provides you a few extra shades which come in handy often. Both are good. I would not say that Camlin is bad or something. Both are equally good. Okay, now I am making the eye because we have this cute little tongue popping out from her mouth. So I'm just blocking the major areas as we did yesterday. These are the teeth. And over here we'll just leave some paint so that we can blend easily. Okay, so we have this here. Okay, we have a question. How do you manage painting and studying as well? I'm an engineering student, I hardly get it. So like the subject that I took, it's actually not that hectic, first of all. So I don't need to study a lot in whatever I do. So I often get time to paint. You didn't clear our confusion about paints. Sakshi, if you are a beginner, you can definitely go ahead and straight away buy Dom's poster paints. They are amazing. They work really well. And if you're asking about the question wherein you asked about the gouache and the other paints, so more or less they are the same. I find no difference, just that gouache paints are more chalky and they have a little more chalky texture than the poster paints. That's the only basic difference. It's just a different name altogether. That's all there is. Okay guys, now let's get started painting the fur. Major differences. So if you talk about the major differences, acrylics is polymer emulsion based. That means acrylics have plastic in them. And then, yeah, now the palette will be visible. I have zoomed out a bit. So I'm taking some poster green from my palette. Yeah, even I'm using DOMS for the first time and they are working pretty good. I'm taking out the greens and we'll be making a different kind of gray with the greens. So you have to take green on your palette and then you have to take some white and black. So let's take out some white and black as well. Okay, so acrylics is polymer emulsion based. That means acrylics has plastic in them. So it dries very quickly and it is permanent, sort of. And it's waterproof. Gouache on the same time is before acrylics, like it is based on the other pigments. And like on the chalky pigments. And then we have the other set that is watercolors. So that pigment, the pigment that watercolors has, is way more less and like it's way more lighter, I would say. So if you want to categorize these paints in order of their pigment ratio or pigment quality, first is the most opaque pigment is watercolor, then comes gouache and poster paints, and then comes acrylic. Gouache and poster paints are like more or less the same. Okay, should we use dark colors before or light shades while working? So it's on you which technique you prefer. I go either ways both the times. Like at times I go dark, at times I go light. So like there's no fixed thing for me. Okay, now observe this closely. I'm making a gray by mixing a little bit of green, white and black. So this is the gray that we will be using. I am adding a little bit of light green as well and dark green, both I'm adding in a little quantity, and I'm adding black. So we got this gray. We are not making gray by using white and black directly. So I hope now you can see what kind of gray it is. Okay, so now I'll make a little darker shade of the same over here. Okay, now what we are going to do is, wish me luck painting without reference. All the best. Yeah, but like if you know the tricks, if you say that it's hard if you use dark first and then light, if you know the trick, then it's easy. So I'll show you how to do that. Let's go dark to light today to clear your confusion. Yes, this will be saved. The live will be saved. Don't worry about it. Okay, so let's try to go dark to light today. So I'm adding all the dark components right now, all the dark paints or on the areas wherever I want dark color to be. Okay, so we are just going with the risky way if you feel so. For me, it's completely normal. Like, I choose to paint with either of this. Okay, now we are just giving the base layers, just make a note of it. Like, this is just the base part. Okay, don't worry if your painting starts to look bad initially, but after adding the furs and all the tiny details, everything will be fine. Do you have any pets? I don't. I do have a cow, but yeah, other than that, I don't. Okay. Okay, so that was our darkest shade. Now we created a lighter shade over here. It's a little blurry. Are you painting without reference? No, I do have a reference open. So I'll just try to bend it down a little. So it's a temporary glitch. It will be fine in a while. Don't worry about that. Okay, now I am adding the lighter shade that we created to other spaces that we have. How do you manage consistency? So, like, I am at a point where I can't miss out on not doing it. Like, I've done so much for my page and everything, and if I just stop, all the efforts that I have put in so far will go in vain. So that's where I gain my motivation. Like, I didn't come this far to only come this far, right? I believe in that quote. So that's how I get the motivation to paint every day and post consistently, if you ask. Okay, I don't know, but will it be saved? Yes, it will be saved. Okay, now is my screen fine right now? Because if I zoom in a lot, you won't be able to see my painting, like the palette. Okay, now I have added a little white in the other one, in the previous paint that we created, and I am again making or adding those layers over the places. Okay, it's fine now. Perfect. Thank you guys for being so interactive. You can still ask me questions. I am ready to answer them while I paint. Like, that's not an issue with me. I can manage. Okay guys, so now you see we are going from dark to light. So we have applied three shades so far on the reference. This is my favorite part. Like, you can lay down the color for as much time as you want, and they still won't dry. Like, they will dry, but as in, they won't be, completely stuck to the paper, and you can easily reactivate them as you add water. Are you self-taught? No, I have just added practice. You added white for the lighter shade? Yes, I did add white for the lighter shade. So you can see the three shades on my palette over here. This is the dark, this is medium, and the light. Now we are taking only white. Please note, don't add much water in this one, because if you do, your blending will be a mess. So we are taking only white over here. Which do you like better, gouache or watercolors? Actually, I like a mixture of both. I love to paint with both of them together, as in use both of them together. Okay, now guys, we are applying white color now in the remaining areas. Now, if you ask me why are we doing this, because we will be blending the remaining shades with the paint that we are applying on this, so we are not making any more shades, and this is how I approach my base coats. So over here, so you'll need a lot of white over here. You'll need a lot of white over here, so make sure you have sufficient in your palette. थोड़ा सा शीट ऊपर करो. सी, आई होप नाउ यू कैन सी द एंटायर पेंटिंग. लेट मी नो इफ यू कैन सी, बिकॉज लाइक फॉर माई स्क्रीन एवरीथिंग इज विजिबल. आई एम टेकिंग अ लिटिल मोर वाइट. मीन वेल यू ऑल कैन लेट मी नो. प्लीज रिप्लाई एज प्रॉम्प्टली एज यू कैन, बिकॉज देर विल बी डिले. ओके, या इट्स विजिबल नाउ. या सो जस्ट मेक श्योर यू टेक एडिक्वेट वाइट एंड डोंट एड मच वाटर. Yes, Ekta. I taught this in the pizza workshop as well with Anupam. Okay, so this is how I go light to dark. Okay, now you won't be scared to go light to dark. Like by saying I go light to dark, I mean this this technique. So you can say that I was being lazy and I accidentally discovered this technique. So now I can't use acrylics just because I'm very used to this one. Because if I use acrylic, I'll tend to just put a shade and leave it out there to rest. And then by the time I go back, it dries completely. I've started with watercolor painting. Can you please give me some tips? Yes, I will come up with more workshops with watercolor because I personally find them to be the trickiest medium because there are zero to very less chances of you correcting the mistakes. So, you have to be very patient with the colors. You have to work in layers. You have to choose which technique you are using, light to dark, dark to light, or whatever it is. Then only your painting will work out. Well, guys, now I've washed my brush. I'm taking it, I'm making it damp. And what I'll do is, now I'll blend from dark to light. I'm using acrylics. Can you give me some tips? Okay, so the technique that I'm choosing is completely not made for acrylics. So please don't follow me for acrylics as of now. For tips, I would say ki if you are blending a particular portion, finish blending it right away. Then only you'll be able to finish the painting on time and like with me and without missing it. I'm using Doms K poster paints by Doms. Now you can see I'm blending dark to light and our base layer is coming into action. Wherever we added the shades, a normal texture bhi aa jayega. How do you feel about your first live on YouTube? Okay, so this my first live was last year. Like this is not my first live on YouTube. I came live last year and it was a very confusing experience for me. Because I wasn't aware कि अब क्या करना है मुझे लाइक बिकॉज द फीचर्स वर डिफरेंट एंड लाइक द चैट्स वर डिसअपियरिंग सो लाइक देर वर लॉट ऑफ इशूज़ सो इट वॉज यू नो काइंड ऑफ हेक्टिक. ओके गाइज, नाउ आई एम यूजिंग जस्ट वाटर एंड आई एम ब्लेंडिंग फ्रॉम डार्क टू लाइट सो दैट योर वाइट कलर विच इज़ ऑलरेडी देयर ऑन योर पेंटिंग विल फैसिलिटेट द स्मूदर ब्लेंडिंग. यस, हाई दिशा, दिशा इज ऑल्सो हेयर. थैंक यू सो मच दिशा. Yes, I will be saving. What does it mean in cotton 25% and 100%? Okay, yeah, that's a good question. So, your paper that you use is made of cellulose and pulp, wooden pulp. So, cellulose, what it does is, so your paper has a layer, okay? So, our watercolor paper has two layers. Cellulose is a liquid that is applied on the paper. Like, I have understood this entire process of how watercolor papers are made and everything. So when I used to take watercolor workshops back then, I was, actually making people understand of what is cellulose and what does this ratio and everything mean. So I'll just repeat that again today. Which paper are you using? I'm using 100% cotton paper by Menora. It's 300 GSM, 100% cotton. Okay, so in layman's language, I won't go in the detail about what cellulose is and the liquid everything because you all will be confused again with it. So in simple term, 25% cotton as in the paper has only 25% cotton pulp. Now the more percentage of cotton your paper has, the more its strength increases to hold water. So like you can apply as much water and add as many layers as you want. Meanwhile, you're painting or working on your picture. So for an artist like me who uses only water to blend and who uses gouache or watercolor as my main mediums, I would go for a paper which has more percentage of cotton so that the strength of the paper to hold water and to absorb or take many shocks of layers will increase. Okay, so that is the basic difference between the 25% cotton. So now why you'll ask ki why there is no 35%, 25%. So like there are various reasons by which people have experimented. So 25% cotton kind of works well with the cellulose liquid that's there, but then the paper that I'm using isn't coated with cellulose. So it's pure made of cotton pulp. So it facilitates, smoother blending and it gives me proper pores for the pages to hold the paint and everything. I hope you understood what I was trying to convey. let me know if that was tricky or it was useful information. You might not hear this often. I only find it out because I did research on what was it exactly. How are you blending? Mine is just getting ruined. So I'm just using water and it's getting blended. Maybe the paper that I'm using is making the difference here. I don't know. Is anyone else facing a problem with my technique that I'm teaching? Okay, so hi Tree Saver. Okay, so what I was saying is whoever is not able to blend, can you please comment the type of paper you are using? Like, tell me the exact name of the paper you are using. I might be able to help you out by telling you, because when I was a beginner, I also experimented with different type of paper and then I found out what paper will work best for me. So if you want to purchase Menorah's paper, I am the brand ambassador. You can use my code PRAFUL5. It's in my bio and you can get 5% discount on the purchase. So you can, you know, buy this paper in bulk because paper matters a lot while you're painting. People might say that, you know, art, people might say that art would need, you can make good art with cheaper supplies, but for watercolors and this, it's not the same. So yeah. Okay, so Brustro watercolor paper, yeah, if it's a 25% cotton, it won't give you the same effect as I do, because as I said, why I am repping the brand Menorah itself is because of the paper quality. Like, it is automatically facilitating me, like blending apne aap hi bahut smooth ho rahi hai. Like, I don't need to put much efforts and the blending is just going like butter. But with Brustro, you have to put more paint and less water. So if you are not getting the proper blend, you might have added a lot of paint on your, you might have added less paint, like you might have made your paint a little opaque. So that's a problem. Okay, am I going too fast, guys? Let me know in the comments. Like, I'm just blending, I'm just giving my base layer because the weather is cold here, so it might take some time to dry. That's why I'm just blending a little fast. That's like my normal speed. So let me know if I'm going too fast. I'll wait after I blend. Can you send the link of the paper? Yes, I will forward it. I'll just tell you all. I'll just put it on my Instagram story. Guys, please let me know about the speed because I'm just blending it and doing nothing apart from blending. I already told you how to lay down the base shades. So now you can see how the color has appeared of the cat, like the cat that you all requested to paint. The cat is coming to life today. And our base layers are done. So this is how we went from dark to light. Okay, guys, please reply about the... Thank you so much, Sneha. Oh, you are using an A4 sheet. Please don't use my technique on that. Like, it will be completely ruined. If you are using an A4 sheet, please don't. Like, that's the... that's not at all the proper sheet for this medium. Like, not suitable at all. Okay, wherever I saw that my thing couldn't blend or I was able to see strokes. Prafull, someone asked you about how you are blending. Okay, I might have missed. So what I'm doing, I'll just show you the process. So I'll just move the screen a little up. Okay, so see how I'm blending. I'm dipping my paintbrush into water. Now this has a lot of water. Now I'm just slowly rotating it on the paper. This is called a damp brush. Now what I'll do is, I'll just use this much water only. And I'll move the brush on the paper. So you can see, please slow down. Yeah, I'll slow down after this. I'm just done with the base. After this, I'll slow down. This is going faster than yesterday. Like, a lot faster. Okay, so that's how I blend. Please let me know if you understood what a damp brush means and how am I blending. Please tell which pencil you use for blending. Okay, so Lakshya Bajaj Arts. I use a Caran d'Ache white pencil. Let me just show you I have here. So the pencil colors that I use are by Faber-Castell Polychromos. And to blend that, okay, I'm not getting my today's pencil, but yeah. So this is the pencil that I use. Please recommend brush. Okay, so for the paintbrush also, I'll make a review video for beginners, please invest in gold Tacklon brushes if you can. Like, I'm using this for over a year and you know, these brushes are really rough and tough and they are perfect for watercolors and gouache. I would not recommend you to use them for acrylics. Buy a separate set if you want. But yeah, so that's my recommendation. If you want to buy detailing brushes, Artishells is my go-to. Even Bustro's detailing brushes are amazing. And the brush, Gold Tacklon brush, you'll see they have this long handle and everything. Please invest if you can. This will be your one-time investment, but completely worth it. So please buy that if you can. Okay, I'm getting this question a lot. Where am I from? Yeah, Menorah's 180 GSM should work fine. Okay, tips on detailing. As we move on, I'll tell you. Okay, so I'm from a small town near Madhya Pradesh. It's named Ashta. So yeah, it's a place between Indore and Bhopal. Okay guys, please comment yes, or please comment I'm doing, if you're actually painting with me and if you are done with the base layers. So then we can start with the detailing. So we are done with the base layers. Now only what we need is detailing. So it will take max 30 more minutes. Yeah guys, please comment yes so that I will be motivated to explain you more, because if a lot of you are painting, then I'll try my best to tell you more about it. Okay, just started to paint. And how are you liking the session so far? Whatever I'm saying, is it useful for you? Are you hearing this for the first time? I can do a lot of sketching, but now I'm not good at painting. Now I'm trying different medium. That's great, Shabana. You should definitely try. Just let me know quick feedback about the live, how it is going. Is it going okay, good, useful? Rishika is also here. Hi Rishika, glad to see you. Is this live going to be saved? Yes, definitely I will save this. Don't worry about it. Please start commenting done once you are done with the base coat. I am done with mine. I finally got to know why I find difficult while painting. Jagriti, can you please let us know what was your mistake, so that with your mistake people will feel, you know, people will feel that they should avoid it. So Jagriti, if you can type it, let me know. I miss painting after seeing you on Insta. Oh Vaishnavi, it's okay, you can definitely start back. Thank you so much everyone for such nice comments. Hi Ishani. Okay guys, so please tell me if you're done with this. Okay, yeah. So if your page is less than 100 GSM, like for gouache and watercolor and everything, painting has to be like, what do you say? Your paper has to be useful. Thank you so much, Vinshika. So your paper matters a lot. I'll send the link on my live on my Instagram. You all can purchase. Do invest in that, and they make cruelty-free paper. So guys, you don't know, but a lot of brands, they use animal extracts and a lot of animal byproducts to coat the cellulose and everything. Cellulose is also derived from plants, but a few of them make animal extract and they coat everything. So like Menorah is taking a really good initiative by making vegan and cruelty free papers. So if you buy that, it will be your money will go in a good cause. So you know, yeah. Okay, do we have people from different countries as well? Yes, I'm waiting. I'll wait for few more minutes and then we'll start. After this, we'll start with the eyes. Meanwhile, the base is drying. It's okay. How do you maintain your brushes? I find it really hard. So like, be gentle with them. Treat them like, you know. Oh, Dinesh is still watching. Okay Dinesh, you are from Sri Lanka, nice bluff. Okay, so what I was saying, yeah, brush, take care of them gently, please wash them properly, use a soap often to rinse the bristles. It will act as a conditioner to your brushes. So that's there. I am from Malaysia. Okay. Thank you so much, Sai Lakshmi. Misa. What does Misa mean? Like, is it something in different language? What is it? Can someone let me know? Suggest some good and affordable detailing brushes. See, like if you want to buy something good, like if you want detailing brushes, please don't buy cheap, because like detailing brushes will help you a lot to change your painting game entirely. So please invest in good, what do you say? Okay guys, please don't spam the comments with your follow request or everything. I can restrict your account. I have that option. Can you suggest me some metallic watercolor paints? Karen, I haven't tried it, so I can't actually tell you. I did got a gift of a pearl metallic. Let me see if I have it right now with me. Okay, I don't have it. I have it here. So I just have this one metallic shade. Yeah, Manya, I'll wait. So I have this one metallic shade. This is by Fine Tech, but I haven't quite used it. So like it's, as you can see, it's still kept packed. So I can't actually say much on metallic watercolors. Like I don't know why people use it. Like for paintings, I don't know. Please suggest cheap watercolors. Go definitely for Camlin. It's the best. Any suggestion? Okay, guys, I'm saying this once and for all. Definitely buy Dom's poster color if you are a beginner. And if you are okay with 14 shades, as you're a beginner, you should be okay with 14 shades. They're more than enough. But if you want more than that, there's this set by Camlin that is the premium poster color range over here. So you can invest in this, you'll get 20 shades. I'll just show you this box and tell you so many shades there are. So there's a metallic shade also, skin, sky blue, pink. And like the shades are very vibrant over here. Both are amazing, but if you can't invest in this one, buy the other one. Sorry, out of context, what brush pen do you use to give shadow letters? Yeah, so meanwhile, guys, please comment done if you're done with the painting. Yes, I'll just show you the shadow wala brush pen also. I have it here, but I haven't taken it out in ages. Just for your question, I'm taking it out. Okay, I can't find it. Where is it? Okay, so I can't actually find that pen. I use Koi, Sakura Koi brush pen. I don't know if it's Koi or something, but it's named as Sakura's cool gray brush pen. Yeah, I'll definitely do the portrait session. Affordable watercolor sheets, I would recommend you to go with Canson. Canson is a good brand for affordable sheets, but okay. Cool, guys. I'm starting. It's been a long time. Now we'll make the eyes over here. So as you can see, I'm using a reference over here. I'm not doing it on my own. Okay, now for this, so you can see almost my paints have dried. So what I do to activate them is I have this spray bottle, which is out of water currently. Let me take out another bottle of mine. Please co start commenting if you are done. Let me just take out some water in this one and I'll sprinkle it. Okay. I'm just spraying some water. So as you can see, now my colors are reactivated. Now they won't dry quickly. Cool, guys. Now that you are done, I want you all to take a detailing brush. Okay. Take a detailing brush and watch the shade carefully. So we will be mixing. We'll be mixing a little more green in the previous shade that we applied, and you'll get a shade like this. Okay. Now what we'll do is we'll just apply that shade over here. I hope you can see this. Now you can see how the eyes are turning in a little viridianish. Okay, so till here you have to do this paint, and then in the rest. Okay, the video is out of focus. Sorry. In the rest, you have to apply white, plain white. How do you paint without a reference? Like, how do you decide the shade? I haven't painted without a reference as of now, but like, after you practice a lot like these, you won't be needing a question, as in where you won't be confused for this, for choosing shades and everything. Okay guys, now it's time to fix the eyes after I'm applying this. What brushes can be affordable? Okay guys, I was about to answer this question about affordable brush, affordable paint, detailing brush. So guys, like an affordable by mistake. Okay, I'll tell you an incident that happened with me. So there's this local brand. I by mistake ordered them from Amazon. So since I was a beginner, I couldn't afford to invest in good quality detailing brushes. I guess a lot of you might still be in that situation as of now. You might be thinking, ki, which one should I buy? And like, they are actually costly. So I ordered this and then the company got to be fake. So I told Amazon that the brushes are fake. They refunded the entire amount and they let me to keep the brushes as well. So my first detailing brushes were free. Like, I don't know if it was my luck or what, but I got them to use for free. They were just for 300 rupees or something. And they worked amazing. Okay, now this side of the eye will be a little dark in this one, because this is not glaring in the reference. And now after this, I'll blend. Now I'm blending using the same. Kindly zoom in. Yeah, so guys, it's a temporary glitch. I hope now it's fine. Please let me know. So like, the network keeps fluctuating. My connection might not be stable. So that's why it's glitching. Now I'm just blending this the same way. Now remember, we added some white over here. So use that white to give it a more realistic effect. Take that white in and just keep on blending with the white. So you'll get some crystal clear eyes, like twinkling eyes, and the eyes will look cute as well. Make sure to blend entire thing. Can you please upload your art room tour? Okay, I don't have an art room. It's my normal room. Once I get a good studio, I'll definitely do that. Okay, now I'm blending the other eye and you can see how twinkling it's coming. And use the white that is already applied over here. Okay, now we can see this eye got a little dull and dark. So we'll add a little white. A little more white. Hi, Kahakashan. Okay, now just add a little white here. And a little more here. Now I'm just making this a little more prominent. Just a suggestion. Wait, what was the suggestion? You can maybe come with a course, boot camp. Yes. I'm just taking the free sessions as of now to tell you all how I teach, so that you all can know if I take any paid workshop, you'll be knowing that you're paying money for something good. So I'll keep on taking. It's not like I'm taking only three sessions to promote my workshop or something. No, I have taken workshops since throughout the pandemic. You can see my previous live and tutorials and everything. And a lot of people are still connected with me who joined me since the pandemic to help people who can't afford for art courses and they wanted to do something. So with this, you can judge my teaching skills and my skills in art. So when I launch paid courses, you can enroll without a second doubt. That's my way, like how I see it. So yeah. Sir, what size of paper are you using? I'm using an A5 size paper. Also, I will be starting my paid workshop session soon. I would keep the fees minimum to 300 to 400 range for a day's session. You can join in those and learn something from me more clearly like those session will be completely different. Okay guys, so I'm using some leftover brown from yesterday's session and I'm just applying it in the middle part. And on the top part, as you know, if you want to make a lighter shade, you just apply the white paint. Now just lift some paint from here and bring it over to there. Okay. Now the bottom portion will be dark, so add a little bit of dark brown, like just take a little bit of brown and black in your brushes together and do it like this. Okay, so now the nose is also done. Now what is required is to just blend them. Meanwhile, let me know guys if you're able to follow me. Am I still going fast? I'm trying to explain each and every aspect of my process as possible. So now you can see nose bhi thodi 3D lag rahi hai. It will also look a little 3D. And then you can deepen the nostrils, like to add depth in that. You can just add depth over there. And now we'll just blend this black color from the rest of the part. The base is perfect now. Okay. Thank you, Ekta. Can you tell me how to make exact same brown shade? So it's all a matter of practicing more frequently. Like I paint every day, so I deal with different shades every day. So make sure you understand the color wheel properly, about the cool warm color and what primary color does, how secondary colors are used. If you want, maybe I can upload some technical information like this also on my channel. If you may find it useful, if that may help you in any way, or you can just simply research on it about YouTube. I also learned from here, and like my drawing teacher obviously told me since my childhood about everything, so I have got an advantage from there. Okay, now I feel like this part is not blending properly, so I'll just apply some white. Yes, please upload those also. Okay, if you all say so. I'll try to upload some color theory and how to mix skin tones and basics of color mixing. Okay guys, now my painting has started to come in shape and the eyes are looking real as well. Like the eyes are literally gleaming. Now I'll just quickly paint the tongue, maybe as shorts. Yeah, I can maybe post as reel or something. So I'll post the reels and shorts together. Okay guys, now I'm using the leftover red and brown from my yesterday's session. I'll just show you the palette right now. Okay. So I'm just reactivating. This is the best part, like you need not wash your palette or anything. So I'm just reactivating them and you can see they're coming out perfectly fine, and like half of my detailing is done with leftover paints from yesterday's session. That's how I save my paints and I don't waste them. Okay, now coming to the tongue over here, mix a little bit of red and brown and apply white on the topper part. Okay, so I don't want you all to waste your time in mixing the colors for this medium. Like why mix if you can blend them right away and get the shade on paper, right? Until unless you're doing realism, of course, because realism demands like the exact same shades and multiple shades. But like for beginners, since we are doing this, you need not spend so much time in figuring out making shades and everything. Okay, now we'll blend the tongue as well over here, and you can see how smooth the tongue has been blended. And then coming to the remaining two teeth, just take some water and put some color from the leftover sides. It will automatically adjust. Like it, you'll get the teeth color basically. You can see how it's not very dark and not very light. Now it's time for us to add some furs. Please let me know if you're done till here. Once you're done till here. comment done once you're done. Maybe that would help me to figure out. Or comment wait if you want me to wait right now after this. Please comment that at least. I'm just giving a finishing touch to the. I'm just separating the parts actually. Separating the neck, the hands, and everything. Okay, I don't see any comments. Also, I do take reel making workshops if anyone is still interested. I will be announcing the next batch soon. I have successfully completed 5 batches and taught over 100 students. Okay, guys, I'm still not getting any comments. Is my net stuck or what is happening? I'm unable to read or see anything. Or like, did anyone comment anything yet? I'm just blending what I did. Okay, now I can see some comments. Hi, Chirag. Okay, yeah, people are still doing. Cool, yeah. Everyone is focused on painting. I get it. So I'm just blending this. Okay, I'm done blending. Is it possible to make pencil color tutorial? If yes, can you make? Yes, I definitely will. I'm just learning pencil colors abhi, so as I learn them a little more, as when I'll be confident enough, I'll tell you. I painted this yesterday, a realistic ice cube, but I'm still learning how to, you know, make different things. So once I'm ready enough, then only I'll start making something out of it, like making content about it. Okay, guys, so I'm done with my kitty. Please at least comment wait if you want me to wait, or like I'll just start right away if everyone is done. I'm just erasing pencil lines. Yeah, okay. Thank you guys. I'll wait. Now you will add fur, right? Yes. Now that the base layers are done, we will add furs and the other details. We'll be done like next 15 more minutes max. Okay, guys, I feel that a few areas have gone a little more dark. So what we'll do is, like, meanwhile you are catch up with me. What I'm doing right now is I'll add from where are you from? It's cold there. I'm from Madhya Pradesh. It's a place named Ashta. It's a city, it's a town near Indore and Bhopal, if you have heard of them. Okay, I'm adding white now for the places to make it a little more bright, basically to add highlights. I had another question I missed. Let me check. Okay, what was it? Please save the session. Yeah, I will definitely save the session. Okay, that was the question. Cool, guys. Now, what I'm doing is just observe carefully. I'm just making the areas around here a little brighter because it is bright. Okay, so area over here, like the entire mouth part. Yes, I'll wait after I'm done with this base coat. And as I said, like, I can't wait for so long also, since this is going to be saved as well. And like, I do have a few other things after this session to do. So yeah. So I'm just making the shades a little lighter to tone them down a bit. Oh, we have people from Indore as well. Hi. Do you add the details when the base layer dries up right away? Internet isn't working fine, guys. I'm sorry. It is getting reconnected. I'm just blending the shades, whichever I have, like the white shade with the other thing to brighten up the painting. So as I blend, you'll see the changes. Yes, I didn't get time to make that highlight yet. I saw a lot of people have already done it. So as and when I get time, I'll just do it. Okay, so now I'm just blending the white color. I'm just toning down the painting a bit. So we got a gray cat perfectly. Let's say successfully. So just move your brush and paint, blend. Hi Ashish, are you the same Ashish from Instagram? Like, I don't know. Yes, I'll wait after this. The base layer. My painting became dark a little because I used a little too much black. If your painting didn't, then you need not do the extra layer of white, but this is just to tell you all that you can easily lighten up your darker shades by this beautiful, cool trick. It was better when you came live from Instagram. Yes, I know it was, but for some reason I have to do this live over here as well. I know Instagram is convenient and everything, but like, it's not that I will stop coming live there, but there are some reasons why I have to take this live. I have to increase the watch hours of my channel. Cool, guys. Now my painting is completely toned down, like my cat, and it's looking more white and fluffy and everything. Now it's time for us to add furs. I will start the furs in 5 minutes. Meanwhile, we can chat. Whoever is not painting, you can ask me some questions or whatever. Just let me know. How are you doing? I'm doing all good. Hi, Vibgyor, what's your name? I'm doing fine. It was a good day. How much GSM paper is good for every medium, even for brush pen calligraphy? So like for brush pen calligraphy, okay, it's Shakti. Hi, Shakti. So for brush pen calligraphy, so wait, for these mediums, you use a cold press sheet. So for those who don't know the difference between a cold press and a hot press sheet, it's basically that in a hot press sheet, the surface is textured, it's more porous, and like the water, they can soak the water and you can add layers and everything. But in hot pressed sheet, which are the softer ones and smoother ones, so you can take a good GSM hot press sheet, so that the sheet is very smooth, so that the tip of your brush pen is something that is important while you do calligraphy, right? Like you can't just afford to let the tip fray all the time, the nib. So to do that, please buy a soft, hot pressed smooth paper. So any paper above 150 GSM that is hot pressed is best. People also do use a watercolor sheet, but I have seen people use them only for Tombows and Karen markers. So if you're someone who can afford those markers and you know then are asking for the paper recommendation, or if whenever in future if you buy those and you want, then definitely go for a watercolor paper, because their tip is, the nib is very strong and they work on all mediums and everything. Okay, so I got an interesting question. If I had a pet, what would it be? So like, no offense, but I don't want a pet because I only like pets in someone else's house, but I can't bear the fur everywhere on my body, my food, on my workplace. Like, I know they're friendly, jolly and everything, but like, I like pet, but only in someone else's house, not in mine. So like, I personally am not a fan of keeping a pet, but I do love painting animals. Like, they are just fun. Yeah, like it's really messy. So like, honestly, I don't want to own a pet. I just want to go to a friend's house who owns a pet and play there and come back clean. Okay guys, 5 minutes are about to get over. We'll start in 2 more minutes. Please hurry up. Comment done if you are done. Okay, Lavanya is asking me your favorite art supplies. That's a tricky question. Like, I have a lot of art supplies, but my current favorite is Neva Palette's Masterclass Gouache and these pencil colors which I have purchased recently. Like, I got a gift, the Polychromos. Have you already planned your upcoming lives for YouTube and Instagram, or it's gonna be random? So I did try planning thing and doing it, but it turns out that I'm more better at managing things spontaneously. So all my Instagram lives, I have kept it spontaneous. I've given myself freedom. The moment I feel that I'm free, I'll come live. That's all. So like, I'm not tied up in my schedule for that thing. I do have a schedule for other collabs and workshops and everything, but I didn't plan out my lives. It will all be random. Is this fake? What is fake? Oh my God. Hi, Louisa. Okay, you should make video on your art supplies. Yes, yes, definitely. So the day where I will, you know, post a highlight about my art supplies will be the day when I make a video on YouTube as well, like art supplies I use. That's a compliment. That was that a compliment? Okay guys, 2 minutes are done now. I can't wait. Like, I'm being so impatient in finishing this. So let's get back. Comment. I'm on, like, you can comment if you are still painting, because I'm sorry, I can't wait for you. Okay guys, now take a detailing brush and take the darkest shade of gray that you made. And okay, I got another question. I'm still painting. Yeah guys, please comment if you're still painting, because I'll try to explain the process clearly so that you don't miss out on that. Because like, I can't wait for a little more time. I have to go. Okay, I use Brustro's watercolor sheets for watercolor painting as I'm beginner. Are they fine? They are good, but like if you can invest in good quality sheets, then definitely go for Menorah. They are amazing. Okay guys, now carefully watch what I'm doing. I'm just adding some tiny strokes. Okay, this is also not working. You have to go for a very, very minute detailer, like way thin than this. So I'm taking my Brustros fine detailer. You can see how thin this is. This is size 40. It's a rigger brush. So if you want to make it look a little more realistic, you can try this rigger brush out. And I'm painting very tiny hairs, or you can say I'm painting fur over here. Okay, now for this also, you have to just paint the fur like this. Okay, so we are painting the dark furs first because they are less, pretty less inside the body, like in the body, on the face, you can see, not in the body. What is even that? Okay. Okay, now I by mistake added some color over here. I'll just apply some water and erase it. So water actually acts as an eraser over here in this medium, which is the best part. Okay, now a little more. Okay, this rigger brush is actually rigged. It's not working that well. Let me see if I have another. Okay, I don't. It's time to use a longer rigger brush. So I'm using size 1 rigger brush because the tip is perfect for this and it can hold quite good amount of water as well. Yeah, this is working. No, this is also giving me a bold stroke. I'll just switch to that, otherwise the other brushes are kept in my cupboard. I'll just go with this brush itself. Yeah, now it has got a point. Okay guys, so you have to go very slowly and add the dark furs first. Okay, now if you ask me why dark furs, because like you will be defining the area where you are painting the light furs. They will pave the way for you. Now, near the nose, you can paint some. So near the nose also we did. Now over this area over here, we'll paint some hairs. Okay, and then a few near this center part. So I'm just painting some hairs over the other sides. Here. And now it's time for this eye. So as you can see, my brush got like this. Like it's become like a snake's tongue. But it's still working fine for me as of now. I have to correct it. So if it happens with your brush, what you can do is take a soap, water, like just dip it in soap, like rinse it in with soap, cover it in soap, and then keep it for a few hours, say 6 hours. He's a tech support scammer. Oh shit, I got a lot of comments. What are we adding on the top? A mouse? No. Who is a tech support scammer? Are you calling me that? I don't have poster colors or gouaches. This is a great tutorial learning it. Thank you so much. Thank you. Okay, now I'm just softening the, like we did yesterday. Like we did yesterday, just soften the air the hairs that we did over here. So just go over with a bigger brush and like don't blend them completely. You won't blend it completely. Just yeah guys, don't spam the comment section or else I have to restrict you because I might miss on some important questions which are of priority. If you want to grow your page, like do efforts, don't beg for people to subscribe or share, because once you put in sufficient efforts, your people will automatically start liking and following your page. So try working on that. That should help you definitely. Okay guys, now we will take a little darker shade, and here we have some darker furs over here. So I am painting some darker hairs on this part. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Shakti, if I'm not wrong in remembering your name. Okay guys, and then we have these cat stripes, no, like this. So try to add a few of them over here. Cool. Now that we have sorted our darker, okay, what is that wow for? Cool. Now that we are done adding our, what do you say, the darker strokes. Yes, a mouse on top. Dinesh, if you're watching, so he's my classmate and he's just simply watching this live and, you know, giving you all evil ideas. Mouse would look cute. I'll try if I can do it some other day, but like, yeah. Cool guys, now comes my favorite part. Hi Priya. Now comes my favorite part, that is to add highlights with white paint. Do you do copper plate calligraphy? No, like I wanted to shift to it, but then painting happened to me suddenly out of nowhere. So I skipped doing all that. I kind of miss calligraphy, but I'm okay with painting as well, so I can't suggest you. Using plate as a palette. No, don't buy a palette, like don't invest in that. Mere kitchen ki hai hai. Okay guys, now see, I'm adding thoda sa dilute white color hai. The white color is a little dilute. I'm taking a detailing brush and I'm adding some hairs. So you also can add some hairs like this. Now remember that this is a dilute paint. So first we are giving dilute strokes. Okay. Then we will give some real strokes, like with proper white color. Those will be the darker ones. Yes, this session will be saved. Don't worry about it. Nothing is visible clearly. Yeah guys, it's a temporary blur. Might be the internet will come back in a while. Okay. Now I'm just adding some lighter furs with a dilute paint. Okay. Make note that first we have to add shades with a dilute paint, because that will actually give you a little lighter strokes and everything. So I'm adding wherever I feel like, because reference mein bahut sare baal hai and I can't just sit and do it. Can you just zoom a little? I can't. I'll just try to shift the phone closer.
Okay, I hope this should be fine now. Okay, now I'm adding some first. Now I'll add some furs over the entire face. I'm just doing this quickly. Yeah, the video will be saved, don't worry. Again, dilute white paint and add some furs over different spaces. Okay, now you can add some white furs over here as well. I hope you all can see this. Guys, is it visible clearly? Can you comment? Can someone comment who's just watching? Okay, now I forgot to do one thing. Okay, thank you so much, everyone. So this side of the ear will also be dark because then only you will be able to show the actual depth in the ear. So we forgot to do this part. So now just blend this like here. Now obviously we'll add some feathers over this one, but yeah, that would make. Thank you, Dinesh, you're still here. Okay, this insect is annoying. How to make color painting fabric? I didn't get your question. Thank you so much, Ananya. Cool. Now the ears look sorted. Okay, so a few more furs are left actually. Like this part is looking very white to me. So I'll just take some dilute light gray paint and I'll make some furs over here. Again, as I said, you'll have to soften down them a bit. They might look very sharp at the moment, but you have to soften them down. And you already know how to do that. That is, after you add the furs, go over with a wet brush. Okay, I got. Have you decided now what to put in the background now? No, we will not be doing the background, we'll just be painting the cat. I don't know what to do in the background. I might just paint a darker shade or something. Hey guys, now don't blend these furs that you did, just soften the edges down a bit to show that fur hai thode thode se background mein, to blend them with the base. So wherever you added the furs, we can just quickly go there and soften them down. There you go. Now I'll just soften down every fur that I've made so far, even with the white ones, because we are all done with this. Now whatever is left is just the pure white detailing. Rest everything is done and this cat looks very real to me. Let me know guys how this cat is coming out. I feel that this is super cool. Cool. We are done with it. Now just the final touch. I'm waiting for your reply, guys. How is the cat coming out? Thank you so much, Vaishnavi. I made the dog in previous life with acrylic. What are your opinions on digital? Thank you so much, Pika Shika. That's a cute username. Thank you, Kashish. Okay, guys, now more of white and less of water. Yes, the live is saved. Live will be saved. Hacker Saruha, thank you. Thank you, everyone. If you have not followed me on Instagram, guys, do check it out. I'll put the link in bio. Thank you so much, Akansha. Yeah, guys, so I have put the channel link in my other videos. So please, my Instagram page link in other videos. It would mean a lot to me if you will just drop there and give me a follow if you like my work. And we can connect more there, because I often come live there as well. Like, more than YouTube, I come live on Instagram. Okay, guys, now I'm just adding final highlights with the white paint. So just have a look how I'm doing it. Okay, now I'm just making the details. Okay, now we have this, making this over here. And where do we need? Yeah, we'll add some details over here. Over here we are painting the furs. And over here we'll be painting some furs, the light ones. He won't do the background. When are we doing another collab? Whenever you say, Vaishnavi, just let me know. Okay, so as you can see, wherever I'm adding the white highlights and how what impact is it having on the painting, I'm just contouring the entire piece, you can say. And also note the direction of you adding your fur. That is also really important. If you mess that up, then it would look really bad. If you want to show our paintings with you, how can you do that? Tag me if you're posting. The painting might get lost in my DMs. So try posting it as a reel or story and mention me. Sure, Vaishnavi. Let me know whenever. Okay, now I'm just blending I'm just softening the white highlights that I gave, because I don't want it to be too loud and to be visible separately. So let's just soften them a bit. Okay, now a little softness over here. And some final details on the body part, like the feet, you can say. Okay, got a question. Is it easy in poster color? Yes, definitely, guys. If you're a beginner, don't go for acrylics or anything. Definitely start with poster colors right away. Like, I'm telling you, it's very easy, and you'll develop confidence that you need for other mediums. So no doubt, it's the best. Okay, guys, so after this is done, I'll post this on my Instagram page. So if you want a proper reference, you can take it from there. Now I'm adding some black dots over here. So if you want a proper reference, you can take it from there. I'll add all my references to the story as well, to my story. Now we are done with this one. Can you tell in which parts you did the highlight? Okay, I'll just repeat. So I'm just repeating it because since the live is going to be saved, I'm just repeating it for that. So if you rewatch it or anything, you will be able to understand. Okay, let me just add some hairs here as well. Since I added black after it, and we should have added this earlier. Let me just finish this and I'll just go through the entire process of adding details. Just give me 1 minute. Okay, I'll just twist it a bit to give proper shape to the hairs. Yeah, so this is also done now. I'm just adding a little white highlight towards this tongue and the nose. Cool. So the highlights are also done now. And we are done with the painting. Now I'll just go through the entire portions again. Okay, just 1 more minute, guys. I'm sorry. This here looks very bright to me, so to tone it down, I'm just adding a little darker first so that it's a mix of shadows, you know. So I just added a random gray color. Cool, now this looks perfect. If you recreate this, do tag me on your stories. I will be able to see your stories rather than the DM. Perfect, guys, this looks super cute to me. Let me know in the comments, how did you like it? We are done with this cat as well. Now I'll just repeat the areas. Meanwhile, please let me know how are you liking this. We are done with the live and did you enjoy the session? Just give a quick feedback so that I can plan more in future. Okay, guys, now, so what we did over here was we added highlights over the cheek part, like in the chin part, around the nose, between the eyes, around the eyes, and then around here, then the corner part, and then the ear, left side of the ear, and a little bit over here. So these are the major places where I added the highlights. Okay, so if you are watching it on repeat, make sure you focus on these points for highlights. Make sure to add white in the end. So I'll just go through the entire process once again. If you want me to sum up today's session, please let me know in the comments what would you like to learn next. Meanwhile, I'll explain this. Okay, now what I did was I started with the base layer first. We started with the dark shade. The colors that I used were green, black, and white. Now, after that, we added the darkest shade first over here, and wherever you can see the darker space. Then we made a little lighter shade, we added that, and finally we added black, white, and we blended everything. After that, we started to add the details, and then the eyes, you know how I did. Then the tongue, nose. For the tongue, I use red-brown. For the nose, I use brown-black. Burnt sienna in both cases. And then I added the major details or major highlights with a little darker gray. And there you go. That's our cute little painting. So guys, that's it about today's live. Now, I'll be uploading this complete picture on my Instagram. So if you want to learn more about this dog, if you want to paint this and if you want to connect with me more, I'll put the link in the description after this live. So you can check that out and you can shop all the supplies that I used with my Amazon page. I have a store wherein I have, I have assorted all the supplies category wise. So I'll just put a link of Amazon storefront as well. So that's there. So to preserve these paintings, there is a medium known as Dorlands wax medium. That is Dorlands. I'll talk about it on my Instagram story. I'm soon yet to make a review video of that on my YouTube channel. So I'm unable to comment. Ekta, if you can, please comment it once so that Jagriti can see it. So Dorlands wax medium is used to seal watercolor paintings, gouache paintings, and every medium that is soluble with water, because varnish won't work that well and it might spoil the entire thing. So that's there. Also, I have taught to paint this cheetah in a live on Instagram. So if you want to learn this as well, you can check out there as well. Okay, thank you so much, Navya. Nav creates. That's there. So bye guys, see you all on Instagram. I'll come live there for 5 minutes to show this piece and tell you all everything about it, and we can have a little more friendly chat over there. So thank you so much guys, subscribe and click on the bell icon for more new updates. Bye guys, take care, good night.